Report to station.
Service lift called to station. Service lift called to station.
Thank you.
exit now accessible.
Communications facility yet? You gotta get that message to the fleet now. Watch out for Campbell and Swan. Those two APCs handle our last standing. Gotta move on.
primary communications tower. Attempt to configure secondary tower. Communication system overload. Communications shut down.
Marine, Delta system computers are showing all off-base communication down. That big swan. Yeah, let's find another way to send that message. Make your way to the satellite room and manually establish a mode from there. Base schematics are showing the quickest way through engineering. You can't fail, Marine. Get that message sent.
Unable to transmit message.
Thank you.
After you send that transmission, get here as quickly as possible. This is the audio log of Technician Seamus, dated October 16th, 2145. Our relatively new remote module replacement procedures are taking some time for maintenance technicians to adjust to. In the long run, it's a much safer, quicker, and easier method. Once a technician receives a call, he simply locates the problem module and gives a replacement command through the remote terminal located in the main comm block. This will initiate the replacement procedure as well as create a repair report, which notifies the repair team of an incoming module. Some minor repairs can be done on-site with normal equipment. I'm hoping the new system will need less and less use once the source of the recent power fluctuations is located and solved. The system is built to handle most other things with its automated recovery systems.
This is the audio log of Officer Ron Ridge, dated October 16, 2145. Recent transport tunnel accidents are causing major headaches for both supply and maintenance. Each accident causes an estimated 1 to 3 hour delay in what are mostly time-sensitive shipments. It's becoming evident that certain junctions need safety adjustments as well as recommitment to driving safety by all personnel. The MPRO to Comm Center route has shown the biggest increase in accidents over the past 6 months. Safety signs and improved lighting are needed throughout the main junctions over the stretch of tunnels and paths. Absolutely, no recreational vehicle passage should be allowed during peak hours. All personnel should use monorail travel whenever possible to keep cargo shipments flowing smoothly.
This is the audio log of Technician Seamus, dated October 16th, 2145. Our relatively new remote module replacement procedures are taking some time for maintenance technicians to adjust to. In the long run, it's a much safer, quicker, and easier method. Once a technician receives a call, he simply locates the problem module and gives a replacement command through the remote terminal located in the main comm block. This will initiate the replacement procedure as well as create a repair report, which notifies the repair team of an incoming module. Some minor repairs can be done on-site with normal equipment. I'm hoping the new system will need less and less use once the source of the recent power fluctuations is located and solved. The system is built to handle most other things with its automated recovery systems.
This is the audio log of Controller James Holiday, dated September 24th, 2145. The recent transport issues from Site 3 have caused the board to call a formal inquiry. We'll study weight limits and suggest better ways to provide protection for Site 3 artifacts. Our equipment... What the fuck? God damn it, these PDAs, does anything work with these? Finish this later.
Francois and Campbell are still in the area. Watch out. Get that transmission sent.
Reinforcements will be here soon. I'll wait for you here at Delta. Get here as quickly as possible.